जिया सुप्रीम कोर्ट में वोटर टर्नआउट प्ली पर सुनवाई जारी है। याचिकाकर्ताओं के लिए कोर्ट का सुप्रीम आदेश। जिया सुप्रीम कोर्ट द्वारा कहा गया कि चल रहे मतदान में बाधा नहीं डाल सकते हैं। सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आगे कहा कुछ जनहित याचिकाएं निजी हित याचिकाएं हैं। कोर्ट ने पोल पैनल और ईवीएम पर संदेह करने वालों को भी कड़ी फटकार लगाई है। तो वोटर टर्न आउट पर आपको बता दें जो प्ली है उस पर सुप्रीम कोर्ट में बहस हुई और क्या कुछ और बातें सुप्रीम कोर्ट द्वारा कही गई, सीधे रुख करेंगे हमारे सहयोगी हरीश का जो इस वक्त हमारे साथ लाइव जुड़ गए। हरीश, प्लीज गिव अस मोर डिटेल।
Yes, once again, a big setback and the stump for the EVM and poll process doubters. The Supreme Court has refused to pass any interim order as far as the petition filed by the ADR, Association of Democratic Reforms and Mahua Moitra is concerned. Remember, the Supreme Court was hearing petition filed by them demanding that absolute numbers of votes polled constituency-wise to be made public immediately and there should not be any delay. And PRI also sought directions to ECI to upload 70 Form 17C on its website. They had pointed out sharp increase between initial and final voting. But Supreme Court said cannot interfere when poll process is on. We need to keep hands-off approach. Supreme Court refused to pass any interim orders and said the petition will be kept for post-summer vacation, that is July 8th, by when the counting will be over. It's a big setback. Supreme Court refused to get into the poll data discrepancy row. Supreme Court refused to order publication of absolute numbers of votes polled constituency-wise and refuses to ask ECI to upload Form 17C. Supreme Court remarked that how can your prayers be based on press notes of Election Commission of India? You yourself have not done any research or investigation. We have to exercise some caution from interfering when election process is on. We cannot interrupt poll process. We need to have a hands-off approach. These days, we must say some of the PILs filed are paisa interest litigation, private interest litigation, and personal interest litigation. Supreme Court prima facie found merit in the arguments of Election Commission of India that such petitions only attempt to keep controversy on EVMs alive in the minds of people in the midst of the polls, and it's an attempt to create false narrative despite Supreme Court repeatedly upholding validity of elections through EVMs and allaying all apprehensions and create suspicion in the minds of the voters. And said this, and the Election Commission of India has said that this petition is only founded on suspicion and apprehension. Such a Herculean task is being performed, should not let such vested interest to interfere, and please Supreme Court should decline indulgence when voting process is on. And these issues have been re-agitated and there's a res judicata bar. Therefore, this petition is not maintainable. And Election Commission also said that there is no end to it. Should this court hear this matter on vacation when poll process is on, this is not the end. They will file more. I know something more is being produced in their factory. So, prima facie finding merit in these arguments of Election Commission of India, Supreme Court has said refused to pass any interim order. And as I said earlier, it's a big setback, big blow for the EVM and poll process doubters. Back to you.
राइट हरीश, आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया इन तमाम जानकारी के लिए। तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट द्वारा ये बड़ी बातें यहां पर कही गई हैं।